I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help. Don't be intimidated by large insurance companies who just want to make your problem go away. We are here to represent your rights and interests. Contact me today at TangyLawTeam.com and let's get to work.
To order this Tuesday, October the 20th, 2020. Mrs. Jenkins, if you would please call the roll.
Are you waiting on me?
Yes, waiting for you to call the roll.
I'm so sorry. Ms. Richards? Mr. Toler?
Here.
Ms. Abrams?
Here.
Mr. Westmoreland?
Present.
Mr. Duncan?
Present.
Mr. Bush?
Here.
Mr. Moore?
Here.
Ms. Simmons?
Here.
Ms. Dominguez?
Present.
All right. Our first item on the agenda is a roofing project for Midway Elementary School's main building. Mr. Schnattelbach is going to present that project. I know we have some others that are here as well and available to the board. Is that right?
That's correct.
All right.
Mr. Duncan, board, this project at Midway Elementary School is a re-roofing of the main building. The Midway Elementary campus, the original roof has been overlaid by a second roof that has now reached its life expectancy. We are experiencing issues with the roof leaking, have been for quite a while. We are in need of replacing the roof. The only thing is that it's a very complicated project, that the exact scope of how we want to move forward has not yet been determined. It is very complicated. We need additional information in determining exactly how we want to move forward. The administration doesn't have the expertise on staff to make the recommendation on exactly how to define and move forward. We've got input from our architects. We've talked to some roofing vendors. We would like to employ CSRS to help assist the administration in defining the scope of the project. We would, as the agenda item reads, we would like to move forward on this project, define the scope, and get federal court approval.
A couple of things, Mr. Schnattelbach. So first off, on the funding for this project, we have a roofing fund that has the funds available to fund this project?
That's correct.
Okay.
You know, we have old roofing fund and we have new roofing funds, and then we have restricted capital project funds. There are no restricted old roofing funds for the Neesum, Natalbany area. This would come from the parish-wide roofing fund to fund this project.
Okay, but it is funds set aside for these old roof replacements.
We have $1.8 million in the parish-wide roofing fund.
All right, and then this particular roof, well, so the building itself, were you able to look and see how old this building
is? I was not able to look that up.
But it was in the 60s, we think? I mean, it's an older...
50s and 60s is what we're anticipating.
Right, okay.
I'm looking over to Kevin if he knows exactly how old the building is.
The roof we're replacing right now is around 20 years old.
But the building itself?
The building itself goes back to the 60s, and this is the entire main building. And we would go ahead and re-roof everything up to the addition of the new cafeteria section that we added.
So even though the main building that we're talking about was in the 60s, we've done a number of considerable reinvestments into this property, even in recent years, correct?
Yes, you know, it was air conditioned, of course, during that time when the early 80s came in, and also there was asbestos abatement done as well.
And then we also did a major cafeteria project
and
there.
The cafeteria was an excellent project, and the kitchen, and then we also did some repair on the skylights and structural to maintain its structural integrity. The building has good structural integrity, and we were able to use Mr. Chris to help us, Bankston, help us with that project to take care of the structural integrity of the building, as well as do the abatement of the other things we talked about, and put in the addition of the cafeteria and improve the kitchen area and such.
We upgraded the electrical entrance.
We did the electrical, and we did new freezes as well. So we brought in some new, with the addition of the cafeteria square footage, we also added new freezes, which it needed. And we also upgraded the electrical, and we also got with energy to upgrade the incoming power to the school, because the incoming power to the school was not sufficient for everything that we did with the addition of technology and the addition of the new addition on the cafeteria itself.
Right. So my point being that with all of those recent major investments into this campus, this is not a campus that we would be phasing out or replacing with some sort of new campus.
No, I do not see that in any future tangible parish school system.
And then the, I'll go back to Mr. Schnottlebach, Mr. Kvitt, and that, but as far as the trying to figure out and define the project scope, is that a matter of trying to figure out what sort of roofing system is best suited toward for this replacement?
That's absolutely correct. You know, the architect has given us a couple options, and determining which one is the best option requires additional information and knowledge on the roof types and the longevity of the roof types and the options available. What we don't want to do is get into a roof project, spend $500,000 or $600,000-$700,000 on a roof that won't give us the length, guaranteed length and longevity of the use of the building, and have to come back and replace the roof sooner than we could if we had another option. So
I'm gonna need
additional information on exactly how to proceed on this particular project.
I'm gonna open the floor up for questions, but let me get a motion on the floor first, which I believe the administration's recommendation is to employ CSRS in assist in defining the project scope and to seek competitive bids to re-roof Midway Elementary School's main building and to seek federal court approval for this project. Is that the administration's recommendation?
Yes, sir.
Is there a motion to approve the administration?
I'll make that motion.
Motion is made by Mr. Westmoreland. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Toler.
I have a question.
Questions from the board, Mr. Westmoreland.
Just one question. So CSRS, they're going to decide whether or recommend whether we seek options 1, 2, or 3 as we have on our agenda?
They may actually recommend another option.
Okay.
To, the individual, Mr. Mann, that I've talked with, would like to, core the roof to determine exactly the condition of the current roof and the underlining roof, look at the total amount that needs to be replaced, and then come back with a recommendation after talking with the architect and determining what he feels is the best approach for us to get the longevity we desire out of the project.
Okay.
Mr. Toler,
what expertise do they bring to the table that we is it structural engineering? Is that what we're getting?
Yes, Mr. Mann has worked. He told me specifically that he has worked over 8 years on just roofing projects for school boards throughout the state.
And do we have a fixed price with them as far as what they're going to charge us to do the consulting?
We have a negotiated price. I would imagine it's going to be a very small percentage of the project. I think we can be able to negotiate about a 2% cost in the project.
And still use architects too?
Yes. The architects would oversee the work, would oversee the contractor's work. That would not be the work that CSRS would be employed to do. They would only be employed to help make a recommendation utilizing their experience on roofing projects like this.
Wouldn't it be better to do like a professional services where they agree to charge so much per hour?
We could. We haven't negotiated that price yet. Okay. We certainly can do that.
Part of CSR, including CSRS in this, is that they're already assisting with prioritizing projects and making sure that they're part of an overall strategic plan.
They are employed to help us develop our facilities projects, and they're working with us on selection of our phase one and phase two projects.
And I would imagine that part of seeking court approval is going to include the court wanting some sort of recommendation from CSRS on how this fits within our overall strategic plan.
I would imagine that could be a possibility. I have not talked with Ms. Bass about the requirements of her motion, but I would imagine she would ask for that type of information.
Mr. Bush, she had something, I'm sorry.
Well, obviously, my first impression is that this company wasn't very well received. And I'm kind of like Mr. Tolar questioning, excuse me, it's gonna be hard for me to vote on just giving these people an opportunity to come in here and look at this, and we have no idea how much they're going to charge. We don't know about it. You yourself just said he told you he's an expert. Well, I'm an expert in too, doing structural stuff, and what they presented to us before in phase one was an embarrassment to me. And there has to be another company somewhere closer or better with the knowledge that we need to spend hundreds of thousands of dollars on this facility. And so give us another option. Have you reached out to someone different? Because the contract that we gave these people obviously has nothing to do with what we're talking about now, correct?
That's correct.
Two different things.
That's correct. The conversations I've had with Mr. Todd gives me the comfort that he's knowledgeable on roof projects.
Let me clarify, Mr. Bush, because I think what I, let's back up a step. The recommendation to fix this roof is not coming from CSRS, is that right?
No, they're only going to advise us on the scope of the project.
But I'm talking about up to this point, CSRS has not been involved with recommending that we need to work on this roof, correct?
Correct.
That is coming from the administration and the folks within the administration saying that it's time to fix this roof, correct?
Correct.
The CSRS's involvement is in trying to select the correct type of roof or way in which to fix this roof, is that
correct? The information we've gotten from our current architect and the roof vendor, in my opinion, I don't feel comfortable making a recommendation to this board on exactly the scope of the project. I've recommended to Ms. Stille that we bring someone else in to help advise us on the scope of this project. This work could go from as little as $680,000 to as much as $1.1 million. Exactly the way we want to move forward and the longevity of the project. If we take the cheaper route and get a 20-year guarantee, we'll spend $700,000 and get 20 years. If we take and look and examine the project and maybe take a more expensive approach but get 40 years out of the project, it may be advantageous for us to go ahead and spend on the larger project to get the greater length of roof life out of the project.
But analyzing that particular cost benefit analysis is what CSRS is you're proposing to engage them in helping us with that particular analysis.
Exactly. I don't have the information to determine or to recommend to y'all right now what I think is the best project to move forward.
Okay, I have a question.
All right, go ahead.
So they're going to tell us how much, $700,000 to $1 million, and they get a percentage of what the project cost?
We can certainly, as Mr. Toll, the price has not been discussed with CSRS. Okay. I have not had any conversation with them on how to move forward.
The reason I'm asking that, what makes them not say, okay, it would be better for y'all to do this at a much larger price so they get a better deal? Are you going to come back to us and say this is what they're wanting?
Yes.
Before we actually get them to do it?
I can if you want me to do that, yes. It's only going to delay the project, but this project's work is going to be done over the summer, so I have the time to do that if y'all would like to do that.
Okay. Ms. Dominguez?
I'm just curious, in all of the years I've been here, 14 years now, we've never reached out and got a different vendor. The architects are usually the ones that know our buildings and know what's going on with those buildings. Why are we not utilizing their
The conversation I've had with the architects, not to discount their expertise, haven't given me the comfort that they know exactly how to move forward on this project. I would rather get another opinion and get someone else involved to give us the recommendation, because the cost of this project isn't $200,000, $300,000. It ranges from $680,000 to $1.1 million. It's a big range. I need more information to make a recommendation to y'all.
Because the last paragraphs or so of this proposal says that this price doesn't include any unforeseen conditions, and it doesn't even for labor or material cost.
Yeah. The quotes that I've given to y'all in the attachments aren't the most current attachment quotes. They're significantly higher than that already. That price, if you think, was $600,000, it's $680,000+. And then there's additional cost if we go with an option two of moving additional piping and stuff. So that's where it really gets complicated. That's why I want more information to advise y'all.
Mr. Moore?
Okay, so one evaluation said that the roof was still structurally intact. So after all this time, the structure, substructure and framing, all that's intact, right? So basically,
The roof is not intact. Keep in mind, the original roof has been covered with a second roof. The original roof, as I understand, was a tar roof that is now leaking down the walls in the hallway that are creating issues. The second roof that was attached, that's over 20 years old, that the warranty has expired, has been leaking for the last few years, and we've been maintaining that roof and repairing that roof to keep it from leaking.
Okay, so I'm not I'm not speaking to the structural integrity of the decking and the covering. Okay, I'm speaking to the speaking of the structural integrity of the framework itself. I mean, are we doing some major architectural change?
No, this building is a concrete building with a concrete ceiling.
There's, right.
The structure of the building is sound. Is
okay,
that not
so,
correct, Mr.
Bettle? Okay, I'm just trying to justify my own mind. Why we now need an architectural firm to come in and make recommendations if all we need to do is recover, you know, the building as it was designed.
It's not as simple as just recovering the building as it's designed. Keep in mind, it's got two roofs on it. So both roofs have to be removed and then another roof put on top back on. So it's a major project. That's why the costs are going up, because we're removing not only the second roof, but the original roof that's put on that was a tar-based roof that's causing the tar to leak down the walls into the hallways.
Mr. Toler?
Yeah, I think for me, the biggest hang-up I have is in the motion, we're naming one company to do part of the evaluation, and we haven't negotiated any price with that company. So from the onset, we're saying we want to do this project, but we won't specifically. You see what I'm saying? We're specifically naming one company. I would feel better, and maybe we could amend the motion by saying maybe striking CSRS. Maybe that's who we use. But just adding in a structural engineer. And typically, I thought, and correct me if I'm wrong, but the architects would then negotiate with a structural engineer as part of their architectural work. So you shouldn't be dealing with an engineer or an architect. The architect should be doing all that work for us. So basically, what I'm suggesting is to amend the motion by striking the word CSRS out of the motion and putting in, letting the architect deal with the engineers to come up with a plan for the school board to move forward. Does that make sense, Mr. Bank? Or is that right?
And maybe work with more than one company to give us, you know, give us some ideas, some two or three people who think this is what needs to be done. I mean, I think we all agree that work needs to be done. I don't think we're discussing that. It's just, you know.
All right. So the amendment, what I'm hearing Mr. Toler say is that that he is moving to amend the prior motion to read that the school system employ our architect and a structural engineer to assist in defining the project scope and to seek competitive bids to re-roof Midway Elementary School's main building and to seek federal court approval for this project.
Correct. So move.
All right. Is there a second?
Second.
All right. It's a second. To amend the motion is made by Mr. Bush.
No, made by Mr. Tolar.
The second is made by Mr. Bush. The amended motion is made by Mr. Tolar. Any further discussion?
Question by board secretary.
I have a question. So it's to employ a structural engineer and our architect or a architect?
To work with our architect.
Okay.
To assist in defining the project scope.
Okay, I have that.
Seek competitive bids to re-roof Midway Elementary School's main building and to seek federal court approval for this project.
Okay.
Just that, clarify. That alleviates my concern. That's all I need.
That gives you the freedom to use whoever you see fit.
Correct.
And y'all may find another company local, or you may find somebody to compete against, but that lets CSRS know, too, that we're being competitive and that we won't. Ideas.
I just need additional assistance on this project.
Absolutely.
Any other?
Mr. Moore? Are we basically looking for a project manager?
No. We're looking for an expert roofing engineer to tell us how to re-roof this school building.
How to fix this problem.
in the most cost-effective way that's going to get us the most bang for our buck for the long term.
The roof and things of that nature, yes.
And to ask, to piggyback off what Mr. Mingus asked, in all your years doing this, this is the first time this particular issue's ever surfaced?
This is the first time that I've come to the board on a project like this with the responsibility to make the recommendation on this type of project. Previous superintendent or my predecessors in this position may have been comfortable making that recommendation based on the architect's information provided to them. I didn't feel comfortable doing that.
Did the architect recommend that you do this, or they had an idea but they knew what to do? And
they've given me a list of different projects with options, but they haven't given me comfort in the best solution to move forward.
Well, definitely, I'm sorry.
Go ahead, Mr.
I'm comfortable with them that they know these buildings and that they've actually done work. Nothing against getting someone's other's opinion, because it's a major problem. We've had problems for the last several years with the roof. But I think it seems like they know the building better, that they could find someone to come in. I mean, that's just my opinion. I mean,
I'll speak to it, because I'm assuming that Mr. Schneidelbach has some level of discomfort. Looking at the information that I received, the architect is recommending a specific product be used to re-roof this building that would limit our ability to get competitive prices. So by bringing in someone with additional expertise, the hope is that they can give us some additional options so that when we structure this bid, we can get some more competitive prices. That's my understanding of what's going on. But if you want to speak to it.
Yes, please.
Brent, so are we talking about a different system than what we have right now?
It's a different. It's just options.
Application.
We want options on how to fix this so that we get more than 20 years out of the roof. Go ahead, Mr.
Now, what? No. The other question I had is, a 40-year guarantee is quite a bit. You know, I mean, that's a promise that, just by my understanding of construction, is going to be hard to live up
Ms.
to.
Ms. Moore, in my experience, Hammond High's roof is a metal roof.
Mm-hmm.
We put a pitch roof on that school when we built it. It lasted 40. You know, it was built in '86. We are starting to experience problems with that roof now. Hammond East Side has a metal pitch roof. Hammond West Side has a metal pitch roof. We haven't had really any issues with the West Side. That school was built in '96, so that's 24 years old. When we re-roofed Independence Science Lab building, we went with a pitch roof. I really want to look at the cost analysis of a pitch roof over the modified bit roof or the TPO roof that was being recommended. So I want more information to make a recommendation to y'all.
And to see
that explains the structural difference I was looking for when I asked the question the first time.
Yes, sir.
We're considering a pitch roof versus a flat roof. I totally get that. I can see 40 years.
All right. I'm sorry. Go ahead. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Sure. So so when I was approached to go and look at the roof and assess what I thought that we thought would be good, I know Brett had mentioned looking at the metal roof. The existing roof was a modified bit that was put over the existing roof, as you've heard. 20 years ago, you could get a 20-year warranty on that type of roof. Nowadays, you really can't. So I got with a roofing contractor that we used before. It just wasn't really anybody specific. It's somebody that I've used before that does a pretty good job. I questioned them about the metal retrofit, about the modified bit, which is what was up there right there. And I think it was I'd have to go back and look at the report. I don't think it was the TPO, which is a sheet vinyl type roof. The numbers came back that he gave us per the square footage. The metal retrofit roof was the most expensive. The cheapest was a TPO. So we talked about it a little bit, and I think that everybody is familiar with the modified bit. It's been used all over the place. We use it in other school systems. And so from there we said, okay, well, let's investigate the modified bit roof. So I got with Seaplast, which is a manufacturing company. I could have went with John Mansville. I could have went with Supreme. I could have went with Firesonic. There's several I could have went with. I went with these guys. I worked with them before. All they did was they came out and went up, got on the roof, made an assessment, started looking at this guy, said, okay, it was a few things. We've got this roof's a little tricky. If we go with a standard mod bit roof, you know, I don't believe you're going to get a warranty. And that's the whole thing, too. The roofs might last longer. You're probably not going to get a 40-year warranty, but you'll get, you know, the roof might last that long. I mean, we are experiencing that without any or small, you know, issues. So in looking at the modified bit roof, to add that type of roof and to make sure that it drains so that you can get the warranty, you're going to have to add like lightweight insulation, right, to taper it. Well, the roof is so vast, I know you've seen it, it's just a big area. That's going to bring the elevation of the taper up into some of the windows and the skylights. You're going to have to raise the gas lines. You're going to have to raise the air conditioning units. There's a lot more to it than just re-roofing it, okay? Mm-hmm. So he said, well, there might be another opportunity. He goes, we have something. Now, this is all happening. This just happened, too, okay? So I haven't really had that much time to investigate everything thoroughly. I just was trying to get some budget numbers so we can see where we were with this. So then he said, we have another opportunity to do something where we don't really have to raise everything up, because we can do, they have a hybrid where it's still a modified bit cap sheet, but then they come over, the top final sheet is a PVC. They have, different companies have PVC sheets. You know, we did a Duralast PVC sheet over at the Livingston Literacy Center for Southeastern a couple years ago. And it's basically welded seams, but it's like a vinyl sheet that goes over the top of the roof, okay? And with that, the warranty does not exclude the ponding, okay? So you will have a little bit of ponding on the roof, but the roof is basically flat, so it's gonna, the water's gonna go off, but if the water sits on a regular, from the way I understand it, if it sits just on a regular modified bit, they're not gonna warranty it. Because they're gonna say if something happens, if it happens to get into the plies or whatever gets down the roof, then you're gonna make a claim and then they're gonna pay for it. So what they're saying is that if you went to the vinyl, you might not have that issue, or you won't have that issue, okay? And then the next one was some sort of, a different type of system which I was not familiar with, and you put your sheets down and you flood it with this, it's like a liquid membrane. I don't know enough about it. I'm not comfortable with it, so I wouldn't have recommended it. So I came back and said, Mr. Cravetta was with me, and you know, it looked like, I said, well, we've got two options here now. Since we've already gone down this path, okay, to the modified bit, we can either go with this modified bit, which, I mean, raising everything, and, you know, I didn't get into it. You know, I'd have to really get into it and see what all was involved, but just, you know, looking at moving gas lines, raising, you're probably gonna have to raise the, or modify at least around the skylights. You know, there's gonna be some structure involved with this. I mean, it could be a couple hundred thousand dollars.
And I don't wanna cut you off, except that we're gonna run out of time. But I mean, you would agree, well, first off, those decisions have to be made before we prepare our bid requests and send them out. We have to figure out what kind of system we wanna have, and all of that has to be defined, right?
Absolutely.
And you would agree that it's a good idea to bring in another set of eyes? And
I'd be fine with that. That's what I was telling Brett. You know, Brett and I talked about this.
Well, good time.
Right.
We had a long conversation about this. Todd Mann informed Brett that he's had extensive experience on roofs. I would welcome another set of eyes. That'd be fine. You know, I mean, all we want to do is what's best for the school system. I mean, right. I don't care. It's not going to hurt my pride. You know, I mean, as long as it gets done. I mean, this is a roof. It's a strange situation. You know, it's not a conventional, you know, roof.
Mm-hmm.
If we can raise it up, and the same thing with the metal roof. If you go to put the pitches on, you got to do something with the air conditionings that are all roof mounted, right?
Right.
And the gas lines and stuff. So there's some other things than that. The other thing that compounds on it is that the structure is good, okay? It's all T construction, it's all concrete, the concrete beams. But what could be bad is the lightweight concrete, you know, they pour like a little deck on top, right? Which is almost like an insulation. And some of that might be bad, you know? So what we were talking about doing is maybe I mean, without ripping it all off, how do you know where, you know, where it is? You just don't. We don't have x-ray vision. You could core it. You could core 100 cores all over it, and you might not get it all. So, you know, in talking with this rep, he said, you know, it might be a good idea to just include a 10%, you know, contingency to replace some of the areas that we think might be bad.
Okay.
You know, and that's all we could do on that. I mean, there's other things we can do. But like I said, at this point in time, I mean, yeah, there needs to be more thought. There needs to be more, you know, study into this situation. And I guess, you know, if you want a metal roof, we can go down that route. We can. If you want a TPO, we can go that, or a PVC, we can do that, and we can do this. It's but I'm assuming it's going to be based on what we can, the most we can get for the money that we have.
Right.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So.
Y'all have any other questions? Mm-hmm. Okay. All right.
Yeah. I'm still going to ask, even if you find all this out, I'm going to ask you, what did the other person say? And what did the other person say? I don't think we should just go to one person and say, tell us what we should do, and that's it. Because they said they're familiar and they're experts. Do you know someone more local? Do you know someone local that would do, that could do this and help?
Well, we can bring in, what I was doing at first, is I brought in, we talked to a roofing contractor. This is what it's best for them. Those guys typically, as contractors, they're up and they see all different types of roofs, right? Because that's what they do. They might do, you know, 3-4 different types. So in my opinion, what was probably a good thing to do is to talk with some of the roofing companies. Now, like I said, I briefly had some conversations with some guys just for budgetary numbers. You know, we didn't really get into the specifics, and he was basically just using Google Earth to look and to see what, you know, because that's pretty good, you know, upper images. And he was looking and he said, oh yeah, I can see this is what we might have to do. It might be a benefit to have this guy come out and, you know, and do it. I mean, you know, any of the contractors are probably willing to get out there to help us because, I mean, it gives them an opportunity to look at the project and hopefully be considered as one of the bidders or something, you know.
Yeah.
We're not promising them anything. We never promise.
If someone actually does the work.
Yeah. Yeah. And any of the roofs that we use, I cannot legally offer to spec something out that I can't get other, you know, vendors on, right? Because I mean, it's a state project basically. It's public, right. So we have to have, it has to be an open spec
that people can, that multiple people can bid on.
Absolutely.
Right.
But defining the scope is really the first issue.
Defining the scope is the first issue. We would probably need to get in and really get on that road and take pictures, and it's like an analysis. I mean, it's a big group. It's like almost 4,000 square feet, so, you know.
All right. So we have a substitute motion that's been made by Mr. Toler, seconded by Mr. Bush, and we'll call the question on that motion. Again, the substitute motion is to employ a structural engineer to work with our architect in defining the scope, the project scope for the re-roofing of Midway Elementary School's main building, and to seek federal court approval for this project. We ask that we...
Voting is open.
Vote your machines.
Not coming up.
I don't see it,
Cindy. Nothing come up. Nothing
not
come up.
Not getting it either.
So,
okay.
Brad, is this the motion to allow the amendment, or is this the motion?
This is a substitute motion.
Substitute
for
okay.
The motion.
Okay, got it.
All right, is there?
Okay, okay, just let me try this. Mr. Toler, Mr. Bush, do you see it now?
Mm-mm.
Is there any objection on the motion? All right, without objection, the motion is agreed to. All right, move on to our second.
Item 1B.
Yeah, item 1B, which is to approve the low quote for Allstate Canopy and Rooms LLC to replace the damaged Kentwood High School Magnet School canopy in the amount of $11,456. Is there a motion to approve the administration's recommendation?
So moved.
Motion is made by Mr. Toler. Is there a second?
A second.
Second by Ms. Robin. Mr. Schnattelbach, you have any?
Just to let you know that this item will be 100% reimbursed by the waste company vendor that damaged the roof.
That was going to be my next question.
So yeah. Everybody's getting ready to ask that.
All right.
Damage the canopy.
Is there any objection to the motion? Without objection, the motion is agreed to. All right, next.
Mr. Duncan, if we can take items 2, A, B, C, and yes. D together at one time.
That's what I was about to do.
Annually, we reevaluate our copy and duplicator needs. These are the needs that we've sat down and analyzed for the entire district for the 2021 school year.
All right, so the motion that I'll take at this time is to adopt the administration's recommendations as to agenda items 2, A, B, C, and D related to duplicators and copiers throughout the parish.
I'll make the motion.
Motion is made by Mrs. Bailey Simmons. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Mrs. Dominguez. Is there any additional discussion on the motion?
Just one question. Why is Hammond Montessori Upper getting two different ones there?
They're getting one for the office and one for the teacher workroom. And the workrooms are configured a little different than the office machines.
Okay.
Any other questions? Is there any public input? All right, ask that you try again to vote your devices.
I believe I forgot to hit the open voting button a while ago.
We got it this time.
Is this motion on here, though, to do all A, B, C, and D?
Yes.
I think it's just A, huh?
I just hit yes.
I think she'll have it.
Okay.
It's only showing the 2A, but it's for
two
all
A,
of it.
B,
yeah.
C, and D?
Yes, this is a motion to approve the administration's recommendation as to items A, items 2, A, B, C, and D. Do you want us to vote electronically, or do you want?
Everybody has, I believe.
We already voted.
Okay.
Is it Mr. Toler? Voting is closed. Motion passes unanimously.
Okay. There being no other business to come before the committee, this meeting is adjourned.
Mr. Schnattelbach, can you report on the walkway in the Roger? Do we have any information?
Yes.
Yeah,
I'll talk quickly. Ms. Simmons is asking about the LaRonja crosswalk project. We've modified that project. We've sent the designs to the Department of Transportation. They responded just this week to our engineers asking for some additional information. They're working on providing that. We expect to get a final approval from the Louisiana Department of Transportation by the end of the month. Is that correct, Kevin?
Yes. And then we'll begin?
Then we'll be able to go ahead and take bids.
After 5 years?
Yes.
Or 10?
Yes.
Okay. All
right. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, we're done now.
He's been that long.
It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangylawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.